Okay, welcome to room number two, Universal Show.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
You're right. Nice to have a female in the studio on a Saturday morning.
Oh, really?
Seriously, get a lot of guys. Look, you know what I mean? Rappers.
Man.
Yeah. So it makes a change.
Wicked.
Yeah, I feel at ease this morning.
Wicked.
Could you introduce yourself this morning, please?
I am Tanika.
Tanika.
Yes.
Tanika. Okay. So now I know some of the listeners may not be too familiar with you.
Yeah.
Would it be fair to say a new artist in the
yes,
scene?
Yes, of course. I'm new. Ground
no,
zero.
No problem. Yes. So give me a little insight about Tanika. Who is Tanika? Where are you coming from?
I'm coming from straight out of Brixton, South London. I'm coming from there. I've been working. I've been in and out the studio for the past 10 years. This year I've brought out an EP called Thoughts of Love, featuring the likes of Sneak Bo, Devious, Zebra Cats. I've collaborated with Naughty Boy, was on a number two record, and my song that I sung, Get Lucky, was the second most downloaded song on the album. And I've come with my single now called Bad For You, official single, finally, and it drops November the 10th, which is exciting. And yeah, other than that, I'm just making some great music that I hope you guys would appreciate, with a bit of edge and soul and, you know, just cool stuff, really.
Okay. So now, for some of the listeners, especially the guys, I'm speaking especially to the guys now because I can say it. I can flip the script this morning. Yeah, now, for the guys that don't know what you look like, I can tell you quite clearly, she's a looker. That's good. But the thing is, the music.
Yes. It's all about the music.
When did it all start, though? When did you decide, you know what, I want to do music?
I kind of knew I wanted to do music from a really early age. My mum has five daughters, so there's five of us, and we always pretended to be Destiny's Child or TLC or En Vogue. We were En Vogue when En Vogue was out. You couldn't tell us any different.
Okay.
So we've always kind of wanted to be singers and, you know, sing to people, make them feel good. And I kind of realised from an early age that, wow, okay, I can actually move my voice and mimic a lot of people and do octaves and, you know, mimic Mariah Carey or Toni Braxton. So I've always known I wanted to do music. It was just the balance of actually, is this going to happen? You know, is it going to become a reality? And it did.
And then what was the channels that you made? Because sometimes you can be at home and amongst your family and they're telling you, do you know what? Yeah, Tanika, you're a good singer.
Yeah. Da, da, da,
but you might think to yourself, I don't know the right channels to make.
Yeah.
So what was the channels that you made to start the ball rolling, really?
That's a good question. I kind of, I didn't, for me, being a singer has always just been a dream. Like it's never been... When I was younger, should I say, I never thought it would be a reality. I just knew that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to kind of live the dream. I wanted to, like, show everyone my voice and what I can do. There's been a lot of channels. You know, it's been, as I said, the first time I actually went in the studio, I was 9 years old.
Wow.
The first time I actually recorded the song that I wrote, I was 10 years old, 9 years old. So it's been a lot of channels, but I think I kind of just through consistency and really believing in myself, regardless of what's going on, the reality or whatever life's throwing at you, is just like, okay, but I want to sing.
Yeah.
Okay, but I need to sing.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. And the first time you sat down and wrote some vocals or something.
Yeah, I was nine. Was in a group called TIP.
TIP. What's that sound for?
Tanika, Aisha, and Priscilla. I was nine years old.
Okay.
Yeah.
Tanisha, Aika.
Tanika, Aisha, and Priscilla.
I like that.
TIP.
What happened with that?
I think they kind of got annoyed with the fact that I wanted to sing everything and write everything myself. So
yeah,
that's when I realised. I realised by the age of 10. Like,
no, it wasn't that.
Yeah.
It wasn't
like,
that.
No, I'm a solo.
You was a better singer than them. Just say how it is.
No, do you know what? Priscilla.
Did they look like you? No, they didn't. Let's keep it moving.
Let's keep it real.
They didn't look like you. They're probably locked on right now, you know. Be careful.
Priscilla and Aisha, my dogs. Yeah, they can well sing. They was good singers. But I realised, like, I need to be... Even for my sisters, I was just like, no, like, I'm Beyonce. Like, this is not going to work.
Mm.
So I always knew I kind of wanted to sing. I'm a solo artist.
Yeah. I'm feeling that. If you just locked on this morning, we've got Tanika in the building. She's here just to tell us a little story about, you know, how it all started, really.
Yeah.
And so right now in the UK...
Yeah.
I feel like... R&B is not really represented that much. Mm-hmm. Is that the avenue that you're going to go down? The R&B route? Or are you just going to be just doing music?
No, I'm
you don't want to be pigeonholed.
I'm definitely, I don't want to be pigeonholed. I'm just here to just do music. If people perceive it, obviously the perception is always the reality. So if you perceive it or you're feeling like it's R&B or it's pop, as long as it makes you feel something and you're enjoying it, that's what matters. But for me, I've grown up on a lot of like soulful music and pop music as well. So it's like edgy pop in one, and especially it's definitely soulful because I'm a believer. I don't need to do vocal acrobats. I don't believe in that. I just need you to feel what I'm singing. That I just need you to connect with it. I don't need to show off.
Yeah.
I can do all of that. Like that's definitely. I'm not here to do that.
So. Okay. So now what I'm quite interested about is the hookup with Naughty Boy.
Yeah.
Because I mean, Naughty Boy are definitely dominating the UK
yes,
right now.
Yes, he's taken over.
Definitely doing his thing. Yes. I think they even done a show last night.
Yeah, we done One Extra live. Which was exciting.
Okay.
It was an amazing night. Okay. He brought out everyone from me to Emily, Sam Smith, Pearl. So it was a great show.
So how did that hookup come about?
I met Naughty Boy 4 years ago now. And he's the guy that's managing him, wanted to manage me, was interested in me. And he manages a lot of people. And I kind of just got a connection with all of them. So they were kind of like the big brothers I never had. And obviously they're geniuses. And I just kind of like developed under them and became good friends with them. You know? There's not many people that you become friends with. Yeah. But he was one of them.
Have you done many performances so far?
I've the past year, yeah.
You've been performing hard.
Yeah, hard.
How much of that work do you like doing? Because I know some artists, especially with rappers, they're more comfortable when they're in a booth environment, but when they go on the stage, they can't really project that confidence. You know what I mean? How do you find when you're on the stage?
I get really nervous.
Yeah.
To be honest with you, the iTunes Festival, I was so nervous. Like for me, it was probably one of my performances. I was like, what, Tanika? But I was so nervous. But for me, performing is like, I get so nervous because that's my most intimate moment with myself and with fans. Like I love doing that. Yeah. I just love expressing how I feel and like giving people the opportunity to get an insight of who I am and how I feel and how I like to move about on stage. So yeah, I love it. I love it. I don't think it's ever going to get old.
Yeah, true. Well, so, do you know what? It's either like you're comfortable with it or you're not.
Yeah.
Because sometimes I see some artists on stage that whose music I really do like.
Yeah.
I don't want to call no names, but I feel like they're out of their comfort zone when they're on stage. Or there are some artists that they're just made for being on the stage.
There are some artists who, like Mary J. Blige, one of like my biggest inspirations, and even Aaliyah, they suffered for over a year with stage fright.
Yeah.
And if you look back on their performances when they first came out, their vocals were never there, their presence was never like as assertive as they are now because they was just nervous, stage fright, and some people do suffer from that. Michael Jackson did, you know, so I'm happy that I don't suffer from it that bad, but you can get to a place where it's like, oh my God, the nerves are taking over and you sound like crap. But Mary J. Blige suffers for a whole year and Aaliyah. And they're dumbed in this.
I think it's fair to say it's true. I remember going to her first show, you know.
She got booed.
Yeah, I was there.
Yeah.
I was there.
Like, there was
with
like
Father
like MC. My sisters went there. I'm talking about like 96. That was years ago.
Yeah.
And I remember my sister 15
minutes
back.
She was on stage.
Yeah. And my sister was a core fan and she was like.
No, because she came on the stage like she was Lady Saw and she was giving it a whole like, you know what I mean? I was like, what? You're in London. You need to wise up.
And she got booed off, isn't it?
Yeah, she got booed off. Yeah.
But everyone's human, you know?
Yeah, of course.
Everyone's human. Footballers, they grow with time. Everyone grows with time. So
what have you learned about yourself so far? Since like when nine years old, you first hit the studio. What have you learned about yourself?
I've learned that I would literally like, it's weird. Just speaking as if I wasn't Tanika. Like I find that it's my sanity. Like if I don't do music, I don't feel like I exist. Like even if I haven't written for a few weeks, I'm not the nicest person to be around. Like I need to sing. Some people do it because they like have the talent to do it, and some people do it because they want to be famous, or some people do it because, oh, I want to show off, but I do it because I need to exist, and if I don't sing, I'm not a good Tanika.
Are you doing any jobs at the moment where you feel like, no, I can't do this. Singing's got to be full time for me.
No, I've had a few jobs. Yeah. You know, from the age of 16, I was working up until like 18, just turning 18 before I got back in the studio. And I got sacked from a few of them. You know, I was personal banking for Alliance and Leicester, and I always used to do the wrong transactions and give people the wrong amount of money and X, Y, and Z and come in hungover. So I definitely know that working is, I'm not built for it at all. Like, I'm the worst person. I probably should have just went uni because me in your 9 to 5, or you thinking I'm going to help
work.
No, I'm going to be a liability.
Okay.
Yeah.
I like that. So tell me about some of your musical influences. And I know you mentioned, you touched on Mariah Carey.
Yeah, Mariah Carey. I used to mimic her a lot. Mm. I always used to wanted to see if I can do some of her notes as a child. Her voice is just out of this world. Her, along with Celine Dion,
okay,
along with Bob Marley, you know, Garnet Silk, Etta James, En Vogue, Mary J. Blige, Aaliyah. So it's a massive, Shania Twain, my mum is very musical, so she was killing the records. And I've got three big sisters, obviously, so, you know, Jodeci and all of that was going on in the house. And I think by the time I got to a certain age where I can buy music or I get my little pocket money, it was the Spice Girls and Destiny's Child and TLC and all that good stuff. So it ranges from a lot, but the legends that came before me, really old school.
Mm, but very good taste.
Yeah,
very good taste. So tell us about your new stuff, your new single.
Oh, Bad For You.
What's bad for you?
It's just I'm bad for you.
You're bad for me.
Yeah, I'm bad for you.
I think you'd be good for me.
I know.
I'm looking at you. I'm looking at you. I think you'd be good, you know. Maurice Fatima, I can see you cutting your eye at me. Don't do it. Are you really that bad?
Do you know what? Everyone's got a bit of bad in them. And I think that the song, the lyrics and how I felt that day, I was definitely hungover, and I done it with Emenike, who's a legend in his own right. Mm. And I was just feeling that morning I was enjoying seeing someone, but I think he was getting a bit too, just doing the most. He wanted to be something it wasn't going to be. And at that time, I just felt like, look, I'm focused on my career. I'm only going to be bad for you. I'm only going to, mess with your heart, so let's just leave it there. And that's where it kind of came from, so.
Oh, that's not nice,
It's definitely, it's not nice. Just got to be a realist sometimes, do you know what I mean?
Yeah. You see, you shouldn't do that. Must put the man first.
No, sir.
Jaheim said put the woman first. Why can't the woman put the man first?
Listen, they did it to us all the time.
What's
I'm just being honest. So I'm letting it be known from early, I'm not in it. Let's just have fun. Don't try and get too serious. I'm about my career.
You just want to freelance,
Just a freelance. Freelance.
I don't talk me a 2013.
Yes. Oh, my Lord.
Tanika. Sorry. This interview's going wrong. It's going wrong.
It's going really right.
Is it going all right?
Yeah, it's going all right.
Nah, man, we've got to tweet each other after that business. This is World FM 90.4. We've got Tanika in the building. So there you have it. New single coming out called Bad For You, November the 10th.
Yes.
Anything that else we can look forward to forthcoming for 2014? What's your plan for 2014?
2014.
It's just around the corner.
It's around the corner. We've got a lot. We've got a single called, a song called Nine that I wrote a few years ago, and I think when that hits, it's called Nine.
Nine. Explain to me about Nine. Can you let us know about that?
Yeah, Nine is, it's about finding that someone that you've searched the whole world for.
Okay.
Not even planet. The whole planet's like this person. When it's you and them, nothing else matters. And I can't even tell you the verse. I can. It starts off with, there are 9 billion people in this world, but I want you. That's all I need to say on that one. But that's coming 2014. That's coming 2014.
It's almost like you're trying to redeem yourself from the I'm bad for you.
Yeah, do you know what? Because the thing is, when you write, you go through certain situations.
Of course.
Even if it's with the same person, you go through, you know, certain different places in a relationship. So it could be to a place where I don't want to be with you. It could be to a place where, oh my God, I need you. You're the only one I need. So, you know, it's different experiences.
I like that.
And we've just kind of written on it and been writing about it for the past few years. We look forward
to that. Anyway, no doubt, we have to wrap it up this morning.
Yes.
Any last things you want to say before we get out the door this morning?
Naughty Boy Tour, November.
November.
It's going to be problems.
You're going to be on it?
Yes.
Oh, damn. I have to come and check that out.
The team. Yes, please come down.
Yeah, most definitely. And can we get you on the show next year or in the foreseeable future?
100%.
No doubt.
100%.
You come and hang out in the morning.
Yeah,
it's been a pleasure, you know.
I already know.
I feel good this morning. I feel good. I feel I need to get you a cornmeal porridge or something this morning.
Yes, please.
Can you do that?
Some fritters or something.
All right, can you introduce your single, please? Oh, sorry. Any information where the listeners can correspond with you?
Oh, yes, definitely. Twitter and Facebook at I Am Tanika, and Instagram, obviously the new craze, at TanikaGram. Thank
you. There you go. And introduce your single, please.
This is Bad for You. 10th for the 11th. You call, I'll come. Sunrise, I'm gone. You're looking like you wish this was more than fun.